Now we are into the third lecture of network functions, which is which module? It is fourth module, right? So let's proceed. So the next topic is to find the poles and zeros of a function. So as you see, three functions are given here, and what is the question? Obtain pole zero plot of the following functions. This is functions, sorry for the that. So how to find this? So there are two terms, right? One is zeros and one is poles. So what we do is, let me use a different pen. So if I equate the numerator to zero, what I get is zeros. If I equate the denominator to zero, what I get is poles. Okay, simple thing, okay. So let's do for part E. So what will be, if this is equated to zero, S will be zero or S plus two is zero. So for zeros, S equal to zero comma minus two. Then for poles, what is it? S equal to minus 1 or minus 3. That's it. So this is, S is always sigma plus j omega. So draw the sigma j omega axis. This is my origin. Okay. So where are the zeros? Zero are indicated by circles, and poles are indicated by cross. Right. So you can think of the game X0. So zero is indicated here. And where is the other zero? At minus 2. So let's say this is minus 1, this is minus 2. So this is the zero. So where is pole at minus 1? Right? So extend this and this is minus 3. Quite simple. Right? So let's do for B. So again, you will require the sigma j omega axis, and this is my origin. So where is the zero? S equal to 0 and S equal to minus 1 again. So S equal to 0. S equal to minus 1. Then pole is at, there are two poles at S equal to minus 2, right? So you show two poles like this. Okay. Then you have a pole at minus 3 also. So minus 3. Okay. So obviously you have to write this. The poles, zeros are found at S equal to 0 and S equal to minus 2, while the poles are found at S equal to minus 1 and S equal to minus 3. I can use shortcuts. Who cannot use shortcuts? This is sigma, this is j omega, this is origin. So S equal to minus 1, again two zeros. So show them like this. So this is minus 1. Then S equal to minus 5. So it will be a bit further. So this is minus 5. Then S equal to minus 2, we have a pole. Then S equal to minus 3 minus j2, right? So minus 3 is this. But this is only minus 3. I want minus j2 also. So this is j omega axis. So let's say j2 is here. And minus j2 is here. So extend this line here. So this line meets here. Extend this line here. This line meets here. So this is my pole. Minus 3 plus j2. Sorry, minus 3 minus j2 and minus 3 plus j2. So very simple. So let's proceed. So again, find poles and zeros of the impedance of the network. So what is the difference here? The function is not given. From the network, we have to find the function, that is Z of S, and then we'll draw the pole zero diagram. So what is the first step? We'll read the transformed network is shown below. So 1 farad will be what? 1 by S. 2 ohms is a resistor, so as it is. Then inductor is half Henry, so it will be half S, LS. And this is 2 ohms, it is a resistor. So this will be what? 1 by S. Same, this is Z of S as it is. Right? So what will be Z of S equal to? So this is in series with this parallel combination. So 1 by S plus 2 plus S by 2. Sorry, I made a mistake. 2 into S by 2 upon 2 plus S by 2. Right? So, right here. So, this is equal to 1 by S plus S upon 2 plus S by 2. So, we want coefficient of S to be 1. So, 1 by S plus 2S upon 4 plus S. Right? So next, what will we do? We'll just simplify this, right? So what it will be, just take the LCM. So 2a square plus s plus 4 upon s square plus 4s. Right. So therefore z of s equal to, but we want to find what poles and zeros. So we require this in the reduced form. Right. So what we do is we keep this as, so what will this be, s into s plus 4. So basically we should get s equal to, right? So again this coefficient we need to be 1. So it will be what, 2 times s square plus 0.5s plus 2, right? So therefore z of s equal to 2 times. So just find the factors of this. So let me get my calculator. So it is 1.52. So what to get is, so remember this is s equal to ka value, right? So what it will be, s plus 0.25 minus j 1.4, you can approximate, into s plus 0.25 plus j 1.4. I have directly written because you will get this as minus, this will be minus only. They are complex conjugate always, upon s into s plus 4, right? So where are the zeros? So poles are simple. So I'll first write the poles. So poles are at s equal to 0 and minus 4. Zeros. So zeros are at s equal to minus 0.25 plus j 1.4. Minus 0.25 plus or minus j 1.4, I can write together. So draw the diagram. You make sure your diagram takes at least 1/3 of the page, okay, so that it is clearly visible to the examiner. So at 0 I have a 0, at minus 4 I have a 0, then minus 0.25 will be somewhere here. So minus 0.25 and j 1.4, let's say it is here. So this will be minus j 1.4. So this is my pole, right? Very simple, right? Let's proceed to the next one. So determine z of s in the network shown. Find poles and zeros of z of s and plot them on s-plane. So same type of question. So again, the transform network is shown below. So this will be what, s only. So this will be 1 by cs, this will be 4 ohms as it is. So 4, so 1 by cs, so 1 by 1 upon 20, so 20 by s, right? So this will be s only, and this is z of s, right? So what will be z of s? So again, s plus 20 by s into 4 upon 20 by s plus 4. So equal to s plus 80 upon 4s plus 20. Right. So cross multiply. For that, what you can do? Make this coefficient as 1, so s plus 5 it will become. So this will become 20. So s plus 20 upon s plus 5. So therefore z of s equal to s plus 20 upon s plus 5. Right? So next is you need to cross multiply. So s square plus 5s square plus 5 plus 20 upon s plus 5, right? But you require them in reduced form, so this should be 3 plus 2, 3 2s are 6, so you are not getting it, right? So what it can be, so it will be a complex number mostly. So let's see. So 1 5 20, yeah, it is a complex number. So again, this is the value of the 0 here. So take the negative of that. So s plus 2.5 minus j 3.71 into s plus 2.5 plus j 3.71 upon s plus 5. So therefore, strictly speaking, you should write in this way. Zeros are located at s equal to minus 2.5 plus j 3.17 and s equal to minus 2.5 minus j 3.71 poles are located at, where are they located? S equal to minus 5. So draw the pole zero diagram. So again, it should be bigger. You can afford to draw small. This is 0. So pole is simple. So pole is at minus 5. So next we have 0 at 2.5. So this is minus 2.5. And this, this is not a pole. So j 3.71. And where will be negative? Minus j 3.71. This is my pole. Right? It's very simple sums, as I said. This is the one of the simplest models in the syllabus. Okay. So let's proceed to the next sum. So this is a different type of sum. So the pole zero diagram is given and the network is given, but the values are not given. So they have asked you to find R, L, and C. So that is the difference in this sum. So the pole zero diagram of the driving point impedance function is shown. At DC, the input impedance is resistive and equal to 2 ohms. Determine R, L, and C. Okay. So just think over it or ponder over it what you can do. So first thing, what is given? That the at DC impedance is what? 2 ohms. Right. So at DC means what? Frequency is 0. So what is S? J omega. Right. So J is 0. So Z of J 0 equal to 0. Sorry, Z of J 0 equal to 2. Means what does it indicate? That you, it gives a hint that find Z of S. So first find Z of S. So it is already in transform network or Laplace domain. So these are in series. But that combination is in parallel with this. So R plus LS into 1 by CS upon R plus LS plus 1 by CS, right? So this will be LS plus R upon RCS plus LCS square plus 1. I have just taken this CS and multiplied here. So this will be equal to, so again I want S coefficient to be 1. So L into S plus R by L upon, and LC I'll take outside. So LC into S square plus, I'm taking LC. So what will this be? R by L S plus 1 by LC. Right? So this LL will get cancelled. Right? So I'll write here. So therefore, Z of S equal to 1 by C into LL will get cancelled. So S plus R by L. S plus R by L upon S square plus R by L S plus 1 by S square plus R by L S plus 1 by L C. Right? So this is what our impedance function. Right? So what we can do next, what we can compare this with the pole zero diagram, we'll get the same function, right? So you can write from the pole zero diagram, what do you see? Zeros are at s equal to minus 2. Zeros are located at s equal to minus 2 and poles are located at. So minus 1 plus j4 and minus 1 minus j4. Sorry, s equal to minus 1 plus j4 and s equal to minus 1 minus j4. Right? So therefore, z of s equal to. So 0 is at s equal to minus 2, so it will become s plus 2. And these are poles, so they will be in denominator. So s plus 1 minus j4 into s plus 1 plus j4. Right? But if you see, there is a fact, some amplitude also, 1 by c. Right? So for that, we use this h. So means we have to find the value of h. Okay? So let's try to simplify this. So this will be what? H times s plus 2 upon. So this is of the form a minus b into a plus b. So what will this be? A square minus b square. So s plus 1 the whole square minus j4 the whole square. And what is j square? Minus 1. So this will be plus 16. Right? So this will be h into s plus 2 upon s square plus 2s plus 17. Right? So let's say this is equation 2, this is equation 1. So what you can do? So what is remaining to find h? So you can wait. So you put at dc omega equal to 0. So therefore, z of 0 equal to 2 ohms. So this is given. So therefore, h into, so s is 0. So h into 2 upon 17 equal to 2. So therefore, h equal to how much? 70. Right? So therefore, z of s equal to h is 17. So into s plus 2. Upon s square plus 2s plus 17. So this can be our equation 2. So compare equation 1 and 2 or from 1 and 2. What we can see? So what we can see? 1 by c is 17, I can say. So just compare them. So 1 by c equal to 17. Instead of from, you use comparing. Okay. So 1 by c is 17. Then r by l will be 2. So r by l equal to 2. Then 1 by lc is also 70. Right. So just, so we have r, lc. 3 unknowns and 3 equations. Right. So what we will get? So let's say this is 3, 4, 5. So put 3 in 5. So therefore 1 by L into 17 equal to 17. So therefore L equal to 1 Henry. Right? This is 6. So put 6 in 4. So therefore R equal to 2 ohms. This is 7. So put 7 in 4. So therefore, so we'll get L. We already have L. We want what? C. So C is nothing but 1 by 17. How? Because 1 by C is 17. Right? Don't forget the units, farads. Right? So what is it? R equal to 2 ohms, L equal to 1 Henry. C equal to 1 by 17 farads. So this is our final answer. Right? So this is the way you have to solve the sums. So as I said, this is one of the simplest modules in the course. Okay? So make sure you don't keep it in option. In fact, you should not keep anything in option. And how to approach this subject is not just open the book and see, okay, isa solve karna hai, fir ye karna hai, fir wo karna hai. No, that is not the way to study this subject. You have to solve as I am solving in these pages. So you have make sure you, I hope you are solving in the lecture, after the lecture, immediately after the lecture, because my lecture are around maximum 30 minutes. So you have that extra half an hour to solve the sums in your book. Okay, so make sure you do that. So it will be very difficult for you.